Heiko lowered it slower. All right, CD BOS, and then load BOS. Hey guys, and welcome to Nomadic Dmitry channel. In the previous episodes, we've been talking about the BOS on this machine, IBM T42, and we've been talking about Heiko OS on this machine, which is Lenovo T61. What we've been trying to do basically just to make sense out of the BOS and Heiko OS and see how those are different. But the problem why BOS was not running on the IBM T42 was the memory. BOS cannot handle more than like 1 GB of RAM, and basically we're gonna also compare with Heiko and just see how those are different. Why even try to compare those? Because I'm curious. That's the main reason, because I'm trying to understand how exactly BOS is different from Heiko. I also discovered that not every single BOS application can run on Heiko. Not every application was ported. Well, let's just compare and see. So all right, let's go. All right, what should we start with? So let's start with IBM T42 because it has the BOS. And BOS, remember, it's not a standalone installation of BOS, but just the one installed like alongside Windows Millennium actually. So I'm gonna go to the command prompt, and here I'm just gonna basically load into BOS. All right, CD BOS, and then load BOS, and then it's gonna load. Let's load the Heiko, by the way. And you already saw the Heiko, so it's gonna start like that. Alright, so BOS loaded, and by the way, by default it was missing the graphical driver, but somehow I was able to install it. By the way, I really like the sense of humor in the BOS, because for example here it says don't knack. If you don't like some error, you can just press don't knack and it's not gonna show it again. But we're gonna press OK. By the way guys, have you noticed that BOS loaded much faster than Heiko? It seems like this is like slower. Maybe it's my impression because I was typing all the commands, but still it felt like Heiko loaded it slower than BOS. But anyway, let's try stuff here. Heiko has actually internet connection available, this one doesn't. I tried connecting the network cable and it didn't work. But what do we have here? So here I actually installed a bunch of applications. For example, I installed the Abby Suite here, and like AB Word and all that. This is just typical word processing tool. You can just start like this. Typical, simple word processing application. But let's see what else, what we have in the applications. Sound recorder. I'm not sure if we have the same in Heiko. Yeah, it's there in Heiko as well. Mostly identical application, just the resolution is different, but it's all the same. The people application, it looks the same way in the BOS. What else? Looking at the disk itself, it says personal edition, and well, it's also like very, very much just similar to what do we have in Heiko, like get info and all the stuff here. But you don't see the indicator, how much space available. For example, in Heiko, you see this indicator right here on the icon itself, so that you can know how much space is left. Let's change the resolution to be more detectable. Alright, I changed the resolution, it's gonna be more simple now to compare those. Both look really, really similar, but I honestly like the BOS logo much more than Heiko. I'm sorry, but this is how it is. And overall, the animation in BOS is just like very, very nice. I installed this one, Go Productive, which is like, what is that? I think it's like, it's also like productivity suite. Yeah, some trial version of this productivity tool. Graphics, spreadsheet, let's try that. And it's basically, again, the similar word processing application that we have. What about movies? I actually copied this movie from somewhere, just a small, and it plays just fine in BOS. Without the sound, unfortunately, but yeah. What I liked about BOS is this one. This is a software wallet, and if you start that one, it just shows this. Shop, manage, download, install. Basically, really similar to what I saw in the Heiko, because they have this Heiko Depot, right? But you can also like shop around and buy stuff there. But unfortunately, of course, the internet doesn't work here, so I cannot show you. And even if it worked, I mean, this URL is not available anymore. bdepot.com. So basically, very, very similar naming. And the browser, just notice this one. The browser is the net positive, and here is the web positive right here. The browsers, even though they're probably gonna look very, very similar if you open the web positive, well, yeah, it looks more modern on the Heiko, right? So it has this URL bar here, all the buttons on the left, but here like all the buttons are on the right side. So it's quite different actually, and icons are nicer of course in Heiko than comparing to those like seem like quite old school. cool. But even though they look kinda similar in some way, but the engine is gonna be different. The WebKit engine here and here, like I don't even know which engine is this. And there's also configuration option here, which you can do what? Alright, it says place all downloads there, place all installations there. Install to select the default folder. Okay, so it automatically installs application to select the folder. I mean, I like to show this old school UI right here. Doom, and I think Doom is also available for Haiku. I remember I downloaded it from somewhere, and I think it's also gonna work just fine. Yeah, all right, open up. Yeah, come on, guys. Yeah, I need to grab those things. So yeah, Doom works. BCafe, I think BCafe is something like for running Java applications on BOS. Yeah, virtual machine for execution of Java applications and applets on BOS. I especially like the CD player right here, like very, very appealing. So I really like the CD player. I think it's also available on Haiku in some way. I have not installed the CD player on Haiku, but I remember I tried it and it also works just fine. What I was also curious about is the Mozilla, like if the Firefox browser is running fine on Haiku, here it is, and it's not obvious how to execute it, but I figured out there is a shell script somewhere here. Open the terminal, CD Mozilla, and then run Mozilla sh. And that's how you start the Firefox on your Haiku. But I think it doesn't work. It just like didn't really work at all. And just say some error, even though I'm connected to internet just fine. It doesn't seem to be working at all. But well, at least we can just open the UI and see what does it say here about Mozilla. And it says this one, Haiku BOS. At least there's some option to open the browser itself. Maybe just for displaying the pages locally. But I think it doesn't work if you try to like actually input something here. Yeah, I mean, it doesn't work. It just always refuses the connection. It just shows like this. All right, what I also wanted to compare, how about killing the application? So if you go Control Alt Delete, it shows this nice dialog in Haiku, which is like kill application, quit application, force reboot and cancel, right? But what about BOS? In BOS, if you try to do the same, it just only has the kill and force reboot and cancel, of course. But it doesn't have the quit application option here, which is like not forcing to close application, but at least trying like to quit peacefully from it, I guess. But other than that, well, almost identical, it looks like. Moho application, I'm not sure what this one is. Ah, it's like a paint application. You're just like able to draw some stuff here, I guess. Yeah, guys, it's like for drawing. Simplified version of Photoshop, I guess, or something like that. Moho. It was created in 2000, right? TV. If you open the TV here, it just says like there's no TV available, right? There's no TV tuner card available. But in Haiku, if you try to do the same, in Haiku you are able at least to interact with the UI. You're like, you don't even need to plug the TV tuner card here. You can just like work with this interface, at least like set up something, I guess. So this is the CD burner application, which I think I tried to find it, but I didn't find it in Haiku. But CD burner application just shipped out of the box, which is cool. Probably it's not gonna work with SATA and USB drives. Most likely this is just like IDE drives, like old IDE drives, and that's it. The camera application, you can connect to the serial port. Oh, USB, it actually has the USB option here. Well, it's quite surprising that it has. The Pulse application, well, it shows the CPU info, I guess. Diamond Girl, I'm not sure what this one. I think this is some kind of game. I didn't figure out exactly how it works, but if you start, it just like goes like this, goes to tracker here. I have not played that game yet. Bmail is available here, so you can launch this one and compose mails. And I think it's the same thing available on Haiku. Yeah, there's a mail application available, and those look quite similar, actually, yeah. Let's compare not the applications, but what about some preferences? How about those? Like, how about the screen? Screen, and it shows this looks almost identical. Oh no, here's the difference. You can actually workspaces, you can have columns and rows in Haiku, but you cannot have those in the BOS. I think, guys, what we need to do, we need to grab this BOS Max CD I have right here, and this has a bunch of additional applications for BOS. So let's actually try that. And let's focus on the BOS. Alright, so we already figured out that basically the Haiku and BOS are very, very similar in many ways, and well, that makes sense. But I also have this CD which has a bunch of applications, and this is called B Max Personal Edition 5. And I think there are a bunch of additional apps that we can explore. And not all of those apps actually running fine on Haiku. I saw that some problems there. So, for example, I was able to run Mozilla and Abbey Word in some state, but it doesn't really work correctly. But talking about the BOS, of course, it should run on BOS just fine. So let's explore that. And what we have here, we have here B theme, for example. And here we can basically modify the themes of BOS. For example, if we select this one and press activate new theme, all right, it's a, like dark mode or something. Yeah, it's a, like a dark mode of BOS. Whoa, interesting. All right, so what's about Copland B? Copland B? Is it like Mac OS kind of theme? Something like this? And then Manifesto for Futurism, activate, interesting. Mic Man, activate, nice, nice. I really like the default theme actually, so I'm just gonna leave it. On this disk, by the way, there are some drivers available. That's how I installed the graphical driver, for example. By default, it was all monochrome display right here. So that's why I installed the VESA accepted, this file. That's how I got the colors here. Initially, it was all just monochrome. All right, so BOS cool stuff, what is it? Just like basically a news about BOS. Upgrade to BOS 5 Pro Edition. Then there are third-party sources. But it's basically like repositories, I guess, on Haiku, right? Big Gamer, a bunch of different repositories available on BOS. Those were available on BOS, not anymore. What about this one? Upgrade to Pro version. Website not found. Well, unfortunately, I cannot buy the Pro version anymore. But if we explore the CD actually here when you open it, by the way, this CD image has B file system, so like you're not able to open this on Windows or Mac, it just doesn't read this. But here it just opens just fine. So if we go to packages, there are a bunch of packages available to install. And to be honest, I don't even know like what most of those applications do. Doom, Exposure, FreeCraft, Blender, BShare, BID, BFinancial, BCasa. I mean, many of those applications were ported to Haiku, but not every application was ported. Talking about apps, those apps are available on the CD. So those, not all of those are available on the actual BOS personal edition installation. Media player, yeah, it's quite similar to what we have in Haiku, right? Macromedia Flash Player for BOS. Right, so there was a build of Flash Player for BOS. If I run it, cannot open missing library. I think those are all available on Haiku, especially this on the teapot. It was like one of the features of Haiku, I guess. You can just like see it works fine in BOS. Minesweeper as usual. Chart, what is that? And this is, by the way, how you guys install application on the BOS and Haiku 2, for example, the BIDE. If you open the package here, there's a BOS PK. So once you open it, this application opens, which is like expander application, expand-o-matic. And then you select the source and then destination. For destination, we're gonna select, for example, which one? Personal edition, apps, and then select apps. And then we're gonna see the content. We can actually see the content, which is nice. Expanding, and that's how we expand files in BOS and Haiku. It all looks so similar, so sometimes you might even just confuse what are you actually using. Is it Haiku or BOS? Here's the thing. You can also open the terminal. And the terminal, you can just type, for example, this one. And it's gonna show you BPC unknown. To be honest with you, I even like BOS more in some way because it seems to be, I don't know, it feels like something original that was initially created, right? Haiku is like attempt to recreate some of the concepts, but BOS feels like more original, something that was actually developed by the company, like a very large team of people, probably tested better, probably, I mean, it's just my assumption, but that's how I think it is. But anyway, like very, very similar. Haiku is just a bit more updated for the modern usage, for the modern computers. Probably BOS is not usable those days because it's not compatible with the modern machines. But as you can see, like on old machines, you can still run it. And to be honest with you, I mean, it doesn't require much memory, the CPU, and like it runs very, very fast. So it's hard to me to like draw a conclusion here. Just it works. And by the way, notice this, when you press shutdown, by the way, really nice animation right here when it kills. I have not seen this in Haiku. And then it's now safe to turn off your computer. Well, of course, like you're not seeing this in Haiku because nowadays, well, you don't need to do that. The computer shuts off itself. Let's just open Haiku for one more second. And you can still run some of the BOS applications, not all of them. For example, the Abbey Suite, which I have installed somewhere. Yeah, Abbey Suite, when you open that, it just crashed some at some point, right? So like, it's some applications work, but it's not exactly compatible with all those. The Mozilla, as I showed, it works, but it's not exactly all compatible. This one I think works. I've tried this one, Visual B. This looks like Visual Basic, and probably it is Visual B++ or something. You can like create buttons, menus, and like develop applications this way. And you can only run, of course, those applications on a 32-bit version of Haiku. Alright guys, thank you for watching. Please subscribe for more videos. I hope it was not very chaotic kind of episode, because I really actually tried to compare those, and in some ways I was also confused because I didn't really use BOS back in those days, but it's really interesting for me to explore, and I probably need to read more documentation myself to understand how it all works. So thank you for watching, and bye bye.